between now. As I said already, today we would be learning a new grammar topic, which is genitive. So this is the fourth case in German grammar. We already know there are the three cases: nominative, accusative, dative, and then today we'll be learning genitive. Just a quick overview before we learn genitive. Nominative is basically a who case, the only subject which we have in a sentence. So like this is a table, this is nominative. Then accusative is what case. When we have one subject and one object in a sentence, then the subject is nominative and then the object is accusative. Ich kaufe den Tisch. So ich, who is buying a table, this is nominative. And what am I buying? A table. So table is accusative. Then dative case, third case, when we have one subject, two object, and so that is basically a dative case, which is to whom or for whom. I am buying a table for you, so you will be dative because something is being done to you or for you. So this is nominative, accusative and dative. Then comes the fourth case, which is whose case, of who or for who. So like in English we have na shoes of my mother. So of my mother or my mother's shoes. So that apostrophe S or of, which we use in English. That is basically genitive, whose, in sense of possession or ownership of something, of somebody, of something. So let's say my mother's shoes, the possession of the shoes by my mother. So whose. Now just before we see some examples, in genitive also the articles changes as per masculine, neutral, feminine and plural. So genitive is little simpler compared to dative or accusative, though we do have some prepositions as well here, but this is simpler compared to the overall the sense or complexity of accusative and dative. So let's see how the articles changes. So masculine, their changes to des, and then with the noun we add extra s or es. Now how do we distinguish if we have to add extra s or es? That is something I'll tell you. So masculine and neutral, their and thus changes to des and des, and then extra s or es, and then feminine and plural changes to their. It's simple. Des plus extra s or es, and then there. Only two changes. Now let's see some examples before you note down this table. Okay, so as I said, possession, ownership for something of somebody or by some possession of something by somebody. So here is das Auto meines Vaters. So here is the car of my father. So here minus Vaters bedeutet of my father. So father, this is there in genitive, in sense of possession it will change to minus Vaters, mine plus es minus, and then with Vater I have added extra s. Why s not es? I'll show the table for that also. Then one more example, das toy des babies, the toy of the baby. Then here is das Auto meiner Mutter. Here is the car of my mother. So the Mutter will change to their. So mine plus their, meiner, and then Mutter. No addition since it's feminine. Only addition extra with noun happen only in masculine and neutral. Dann hast du die Freunde meiner Schwester gesehen? Have you seen the friend of my sister? Freunde meiner Schwester, friend of my sister. Auto meines Vaters, car of my father. Toy des babies, toy of द बेबी आउटो माई नेफ मुटर कार ऑफ माई मदर. आर दीज एग्जाम्पल्स क्लियर?
Yes.
Okay. Let's see some more examples. Little complex to understand the meaning in detail. I'm Aunt Fang. Rachel, could you quickly read these two sentences?
I'm Aunt Fang. This curses have been fear, feel, learn. One shares Zaiten des Bukes Pelen. Pages of the book are missing.
Yes. So I'm Anfang des courses of the course. In the beginning of the course. I'm Anfang in the beginning des courses of the course. We have learned a lot. So this is the section you have to pay attention to in the beginning of the course. And then the rest of the sentence. Similarly here, manche Seiten, a lot of pages of the book. Seiten des Buches, pages of the book. Book is das book. So des and then extra es, fehlen. So most of the pages of the book are missing. So it's pretty simple to learn as long as you remember that masculine neutral will change to des and then feminine and plural will change to their. Now the question comes, where will you add extra s like here and where will you add extra es like here? So here is the quick table for you. So there are some endings which will decide, or a type of a noun will decide whether to add s or to add extra es. Zum Beispiel, ein selbiger Nomen. So ein selbiger Nomen means when we have just one vowel in the noun, then we will add extra es. Zum Beispiel, des Mannes. Des Buches, des Babies. I know that. So baby here is an exception case. Des Buches. Or if there's any word which is ending with S, sharpes S, X or etc. Then we will add extra es. Zum Beispiel, des Hauses. House, which is ending with s, then we will add extra es of the house. Die Tür, des Hauses, the door of the house. Das Dauer des Kurses. Course, the duration of the course. So ending with S, so I have added extra ES. Then mehr selbiger Nomen means when we have more than one vowel in a word, then we will add only S. Zum Beispiel, des Vaters, des Onkels, oder yep. So just to summarize, when we have one vowel only in a word, then we will add extra ES, or any ending which any word which is ending with S, sharpest S, X or Z, then also we will add extra ES. If there is more than one vowel in a word, then we will add only S. And of course, there are some exceptions like babies. So with baby we will add babies, not babies. So baby is like exception. So now before we see some more example or do some more practice, quickly make this table and then note down this one. Let me know once you need me to scroll down.
Examples also.
Saurabh, are you saying something?
Yeah, we need to write examples also.
No, just this one.
You can scroll down.
Okay.
Scriben.
Okay, Rachel. Anji, Sora, geschrieben. Should we proceed?
Geschrieben.
Okay. So this is basically a one way of writing genitives when we are changing their to this, then das to this, the to their, and then the to their. Now this is this usually happens when we have noun basically. But what if we have a name? If instead of saying my brother's book, I will use my brother's name and then I will say it. So now similarly, like in English, we put the name and then we add apostrophe s. In English, we do almost the same process in German when we have the name of a person. It's just we add extra s with the name, like in this example, but we don't add apostrophe. So Maria's Freund heißt Thomas. Rachel's friend Freund heißt Angie. Angie's Freund heißt Rachel. So we will write the name and then we will add extra s without apostrophe. So this is the first case. So this is like either you can write it this way, Maria's Freund heißt Thomas, or their Freund meiner Schwester heißt Thomas. Let's say I have a sister whose name is Maria. So either I can say Maria's Freund heißt Thomas, or I can say their Freund meiner Schwester, the friend of my sister names Thomas. So this is the one way of writing. Now what if any name itself is ending with s? Then we will not add extra s here. No, we won't write it this way. Let's say for example Hans, that is ending with s. I will not say Hans's Mutter ist nett. No, I will just say Hans, and then in writing I will add this extra apostrophe after s. So it won't go like this. It won't go rather it will be like this. So we will write the whole name, something which is ending with s, and then apostrophe. So Hans Mutter ist nett, oder die Mutter meines Freundes ist nett. Similarly here, Wisconsin, the name, then Wisconsin's Hauptstadt ist Madison. The Hauptstadt dieses Bundeslands ist Madison. So this is the name of a place. We have added extra s with that. So this is another way of writing. Now just note down this as mentioning the second way of writing genitive. Guys, please mute yourself. geschrieben.
Geschrieben.
Okay. So now we have one. Since we have learned that genitive is all about possession or ownership of something to somebody or of or apostrophe s, so either we can write something like this, either with genitive, or we have one alternate method also. So either way you can write it, either you can write it in genitive form, or instead of writing genitive you can use simply phone, like here, das Haus meines Freundes. The house of my friend. Or either you can write it here like this in genitive way, oder das Haus von meinem Freund. So instead of using genitive, you can simply use von as a preposition, but then the sentence will not remain genitive, it will change to dative. This von is a dative preposition. So von meinem Freund. Similarly, der Onkel meiner Mutter, oder der Onkel von meiner Mutter. So here also is meiner and here also is meiner. So either you can write it like this in a genitive way, or like this, like this in dative way, or like this in genitive way. Then the Namen der Kinder, the name of the children, oder the Namen von den Kindern, the names of the children. It's one and the same thing, it just depends how you want to write your sentence. You want to note down this also, or should we proceed with the examples? More examples? Okay. So this is basically the preposition section, which we will do after some time. Then one quick information, when it comes to if we have to, you know, place a question in sense of genitive, like whose car is this, whose book is this, whose dress is this, so whose is our genitive case. So for that we use wesen. Wesen Auto ist das. Wesen Bücher liegen hier. So wesen basically means whose, like where is who, was is. For accusative, wem is für dative. Similarly wesen, that is for genitive. So one more thing, either you can write it like this way, wesen Auto ist das, das ist genitive, or you can write wem gehörst, gehören, that means to belong. Wem gehört diesem Auto. But here this sentence will become dative, because wem is a dative W question, and then gehören is also a dative verb. So gehören is a fixed dative verb. So either for, let's say, you have this question, wesen Auto ist das, das Auto ist meines Vaters, this car is of my father, or here you can also answer diesem Auto, dieses Auto gehört mir. So here, since it's belonging to me, I am the dative case here, I will be using mir, because gehören is a dative verb, so I won't write dieses Auto gehört ich, I will say mir, that it belongs to me. So for both the answers, wesen or wem gehört, you can answer in this manner. Please note this down. Just these two examples. Okay, so just to clarify a little more, either you can write mir or my name father. This car belongs to my father, or this is my father's car. Okay, now let's proceed further with some examples. Just give me a minute. Guys, just give me a minute. I'm not able to find the different sheet for practice. Just a minute. Okay, so here we have some examples. Each one of you will read one sentence and then we'll try to find the answer. Rachel, can you start reading from here? The hints which are to be used are given in the bracket.
Is this house?
Schwester is the Schwester, na? So is that house of your sister? Is this the house of your sister? So, deiner. Deine Schwester. Read this one also.
Nein. Das ist das Haus What is that? Großeltern.
Großeltern, grandparents.
Das ist das Haus unserer Großeltern.
Sehr schön. Unserer. That is the house of our grandparents. Unserer Großeltern. Okay. Next, Nummer zwei. Angie.
Okay. Das ist die neue Freundin meines Bruders.
Meines
Bruders.
Only S.
So das ist
Ein Moment. So das ist.
So this is.
Here is the name now. This is Klaus' friend. We will write okay. Klaus as it is because Klaus is ending with S.
Yes.
Then we'll add that extra apostrophe here after S.
Okay.
So das ist Klaus' Freundin. We won't say Klaus's Freundin because that is like English when we say Klaus's. But here we'll just say Klaus' Freundin, and in writing we'll add extra apostrophe. Then Nummer drei, Saurabh, could you please read that?
Is this Karin's son?
So Karin's. We won't add any apostrophe, just Karin and then extra S. So is that yeah. Karin's son? Is this Karin's son? Karin.
Nein, das ist Sohn meiner Arzt.
Arzt is their Arzt. Sort of.
It's their.
No, mein Arzt. So how should I write that this is the son of my doctor? So how should I write mein Arzt to change it to genitive?
Yeah. Minus.
And then
minus arts. Arts.
Arts.
Arts
will be gonna just one A. So arts.
Yeah, minus arts. Arts.
Okay. Now, this is a little trickier exercise which you will write in your copy. So what you have to do here, there is one sentence given in English. You have to write it in German. I'll give you one example. So my sister's husband. So whenever there is anything, let's say written with apostrophe S, when you change it to genitive, try to change it in the sense of. So instead of thinking like my sister's husband is very nice, in genitive, you will write the husband of my sister. So it will be like der Mann meiner Schwester ist der nett. Similarly, I went to my friend's party. So, I went to the party of my friend. I don't know your father's name. I don't know the name of your father. Is this your roommate's computer? So, is this the computer of your roommate? Computer of your roommate. Name of your father. Address of your teacher. So that's how you should write it in German. Address of your teacher, computer of your roommate, name of your father, party of the friend.
What will be for the second one? I went to my friend's party.
I went to the party of my friend. Party meines Freundes.
Okay.
And this is perfect. You would have to write this past tense, na? So try to write it in perfect.
Whole sentences. We have to write the whole sentences.
Yes, you have to write whole sentence. Like for example, here der Mann meiner Schwester ist sehr nett.
is for wind. So gehen, we use the gehen. So for wind, what will we hear?
Gegangen.
Gegangen.
Perfect, na? You'll have to write it in perfect. Geschrieben? Okay, so I'll write the answers here and then you can cross-check. In case of any confusion or anything which you have written wrong, let me know. I'll explain in detail. So I will. Sorry?
No need to send.
No. I'll just write the answers here and you can cross-check. I went to my friend's party. So I went to the party of my friend. Ich bin sehr schön, Rachel. So a party.
Meines Freundes gegangen.
Sehr schön. Richtig geschrieben. Angie, you have also written the same?
No.
Then what you have written?
That Freundes. Because it has more than one vowel. So it's supposed to be single S only. No.
Sorry.
So Freunds, not Freundes. Okay.
And then I don't know your father's name. Der Name, your friend's name, sorry, not father's. Der Name deines Freundes weiß. Ich nicht. Is this the same you have written?
Let me know.
Then what you have written, please read.
Ish kehne dena me dinus pointe points nish.
That is also correct. Ish kehna or ish vice. It won't be canon. So there is a basic difference between wissen and canon. I'll explain it. That is not your fault. These are like, you know, false friends, you can say. So there are some confusing words. I'll clear the difference. So ich weiß die Name. So either you can put this weiß in beginning and then the rest of the sentence later. But the verb for knowing is something which we'll use wissen. So there are two words. This is something you can also note down in your copy. Wissen. And then canon. So wissen also means to know. Canon also means to know. Wissen is more towards a thing. I don't know something. So name is a thing. But when you say I don't know your friend, then you will use canon. That nice to know you. So when you meet somebody, you say schön sie kennen zu lernen. Kennen lernen is basically a separable verb, which means to know somebody. Let's say you meet somebody at your workplace who is new to you, then you will say schön sie kennen zu lernen. That means nice to know you. So kennen is something which we use to know for a person, and wissen is something which we use for thing. So here we will be using wissen, not kennen. Had it been like I don't know your friend, then I would have written ich kenne deine, like I don't know your friend. So then for that I would have used kennen. Clear?
Not clear.
Please make a note of it. To know, that is for things, and then this also means to know, and then this is for people. Okay, the next is this your roommate's computer. Rachel, what you have written, can you read?
Is this the computer is my divorce?
Is there computer dinus nurse. Angie, Saurabh, have you also written the same?
For me, I use erase.
Okay. Yes, one
and the,
yes. So you have used in a formal way.
Yeah.
That is also correct. Then the last one, Angie, what you have written for this one?
Ich habe die Adresse des Lehrers vergessen.
Das ist richtig.
Okay.
Ich habe die Adresse des Lehrers
vergessen.
So either you could have written in this way, like ich habe in the beginning, oder the adresse des Lehrers. Either you can write it this way or this way. The adresse des Lehrers habe ich vergessen. The address of the teacher I have forgot. Beide sind richtig. Okay? Clear? Okay. So tomorrow we will practice something more from the same sheet. And then we will learn the genitive prepositions also. So we have some genitive prepositions. That is something we learn tomorrow.
Neha, can you share this today?
Yes. Okay. I'll share it.
And would you also?
Okay. I would like by late night.
Okay. Thanks, Neha.
Okay. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye. Take care.
Thank you.